Now, I've got Roger Serong here with me. Now, Roger, this is a very unusual aircraft. I haven't seen anything like it, not only because of a push prop, but can you tell us more about it?
Yes, it's called a Sky Arrow. They're manufactured in Italy, and this is one of two in Australia. It was the only one until 2005 when another arrived over in Perth, and we had both together at Cowra in 2007 for a Sport Aircraft Association of Australia meet, and they look lovely together. But they're a beautiful aircraft, and they were originally developed as a reconnaissance aircraft for the Italian military. And it was the first light aircraft to be manufactured entirely out of carbon fibre and with Kevlar reinforcing around the cockpit. So they were quite advanced for their day in the early 90s.
Oh, right, OK. Now, it's unusual that it's a two-seater, but you've sort of one behind the other. It reminds me a lot of a Drifter, the open cockpit ultralight. That's a bit unusual, isn't it?
It is, and I guess it gives a clue to its military origins, because a lot of military training aircraft were tandem with one behind the other. You can fly it from the back seat, so it would actually be good for instructional purposes, and with the student in the front and the instructor in the back. But it's lovely to fly and excellent visibility. It appeals to glider pilots. It looks a little bit like a glider in the front.
That's exactly right. I was going to say that. Now, how long have you had it for?
I've had it since 2005. It was brought into Australia in 1999 for the Avalon Air Show that year, and I was lucky enough to buy it from the manufacturer in 2005, and I've flown it ever since.
Yeah. Now, what's it powered by?
It's got a 80 horsepower Rotax 912F engine in it, and they're a prolific engine amongst light aircraft, and very reliable, and it's been a good performer.
Yeah, well, that's the similarity between an ultralight and this one, isn't it? I mean, even the Rotax, the engine on it.
Yes, that's true, and you can get an ultralight model. This is a little bit too heavy, it's 650 kilograms, but this is a fully factory certified VH registered aircraft, which is also night VFR.
Oh, wow. That's brilliant. Now, where did you fly in from?
I flew from Tyab. I keep it based at Tyab in Victoria.
Oh, fantastic. Now, look, full credit to you. It's an absolutely beautiful plane, and like I said, very unusual to see a push prop these days.
It is, yeah, and it's rather unusual. It's always nice to see the prop spinning in front of you. You want to make sure it's still spinning behind you, actually.
That's exactly right. Well, mate, congratulations, and yeah, thanks for giving us a bit of your time today.
Thank you very much.
No worries.
There's also another story in terms of the diabetes. I've got type 1 diabetes.
Oh, yeah.
And I became the first licensed pilot in Australia to be able to fly solo with type 1 diabetes.
Oh, well, congratulations, mate.
Yeah, and it took a fair bit of doing. I had to run a case at the Administrative Appeals Tribunal because CASA wouldn't allow it. But I won my case and I became the first pilot to be able to do that. So that's a real privilege too.
Well, good on you. Yeah, I'm sure you made mention of that. Now, I suppose that opens the door for other pilots that might be considering.
It does, and since then CASA has altered the regulations, and there's a strict procedure that we have to follow, like testing our blood glucose before and during flight. But provided you do that and you keep it within the required limits and you don't have any complications from the disease, it's quite safe. But it takes a lot of attention to detail and monitoring, but then again, that's what pilots have to do in terms of flying safely.
That's right, that's part of the regimented procedure, I guess, that you've got to follow. And yeah, full credit to you, well done.
Indeed, no, thanks very much, it's been great.
No worries, thanks very much, Roger.
Okay.